I'm Ms. Lormy Cagande.
Okay, from the Department of Agronomy under the College of Agriculture and Food Science. So this time, after Ms. Borny, you have talked about the expected output for education students. I am tasked to deliver to you the expected output for students under agriculture-related courses. So who are these students under Bachelor of Science in Agriculture, Bachelor of Science, Animal Science students, and so on. Okay, so a while ago, Mr. Villan have already talked about the proposal writing on what to do and what the format are being included. For agriculture, enable for you to have a proposal, you read about gardening. So examples for this are home gardening, container gardening, and some others. So you read, you scan, you browse in the internet so that you can have an idea on how to conceptualize your proposal. So these are part of the proposal. So you have the introduction, objectives, and you include materials and methods, of course. Then after that, you have already the idea, you have already conceptualized your proposal. You can start your project. So since I'm under the agriculture, so example is gathering of needed materials such as soil medium, seeds, pots, and fertilizers. So the skill, your skill of being resourceful will be used in this step, no? So maggamit mo og mga materials such as soil medium. So if you have some compostings in your area, in your houses, if you have rice farm, then you can use it as a soil medium together with the garden soil. And also seeds. So you cannot start your gardening if you don't have the seeds. So it is a very important input for you to start your project. Then pots. So if you don't have enough pots, kanang like maglisod mo og purchase, there's a difficulty in purchasing your pots, you can use some recyclable materials. Okay. So mga empty, mga container bottles, so you can use that as your pots. And also, if needed, fertilizers. But I think we have some different manures that will be already available in your locality. So you can collect all those things, different manures like carabao manures, feces of chickens, okay, cow manure, so you can use that as your fertilizers. Then for sowing, okay, so you have already the seeds, you have already the pots, your soil medium, and you can now start sowing the seeds. And after that, you care and maintenance. Okay. So in care and maintenance, if there's a need to water your plants, okay, you take all those management practices. If you have observed some pests, so na yung mga insekto dira sa inyong nitubo ng mga plants, okay, remove those one kung naa kay makadaot sa inyong gardening. Okay, so care and maintenance. And so also, if you have observed mga also kanang pest, you can make pesticides or manual picking is already advised. Okay na siya if lesser damage to plants lang. Then after that, after all the care and maintenance, the different management practices, yeah, you can have harvesting. So this is the final output, okay, of your projects of harvesting. To ensure food security, you have to have a harvest para may magamit and makonsume sa inyong family and also to your extended families. And also mga neighborhood, mahatagan ninyo. Okay. So after you conduct, so all throughout the implementation of your project, you take photos and videos, of course, para naamoy magamit para sa inyong digital stories. Example, so pag-prepare sa inyong materials, pag-procure ninyo adto, you take pictures in sowing of seeds, you take pictures, care and maintenance. So what did you do? In caring and maintaining your plants, so inyo tong i-picture. Maski less quality, basta na ay makuha nga pictures, okay na siya for digital stories. Then for weekly observation, okay, for weekly observation, so every week, you monitor naunsa na ang inyong mga plants. Okay, then harvesting, so mana harvesting, so documentations, and so on. So after the documentation process, you write a script, okay. So, gisultin na ni ganina ni Ma'am Borneo, no? Writing a script, create a storyline or storyboards from the start to the end of your project. Then, you create a digital story. So, you have already gathered audios and videos. Then, after that, you do the voice over. So, you limit your story to 3 to 5 minutes only. 5 minutes is the maximum. Okay? Then, after that, you have already furnished, finished, re-reviewed your digital stories, it is the time for you to send your output to your respective team facilitators / coordinators. Okay, then you can share it to social media accounts. If you have Facebook, naamang yun siguro Facebook karon. Okay, Facebook, Instagram, and other social media accounts. Okay? So, I think that's all for my topic about gardening, ensuring food security. That's all. Thank you.